Attorney General Jeff Sessions quietly working to overhaul the Justice Department one piece at a time and bring in a new era that reverses some of the work that was done by the former Attorney General and the head of the department, Eric Holder and Loretta Lynch. He's on immigration, crime, police reform, all of those taking center stage for Jeff Sessions now. Here to debate this, David Wohl, attorney and supporter of President Trump, Richard Fowler, nationally syndicated radio show host and Fox News contributor. Welcome, gentlemen. Good to have you here.
Hi,
so police reforms, Richard, is where we can start here. Your thoughts on what Jeff Sessions has done so far?
Well, it's been 83 days of horror from this attorney general. Clearly, he's trying to set up some sort of ethno-nationalist utopia where police can get away with anything, right? Where Muslims aren't allowed into the country, where transgendered students don't get the protections they deserve, and where minorities don't have the right to vote. That is the world that Jeff Sessions wants. And to be honest with you, Martha, and the viewers might not like it at home, but I'm not having it. This is not what the Justice Department is supposed to be. For decades, it has been the department that stood up for everyday Americans, for everyday citizens. Under Jeff Sessions, it stands up for private prisons, it stands up for this far, far right extreme agenda, and it hurts everyday Americans.
You know, I mean, that is the argument from the left, no doubt. Jeff Sessions, though, you know, I mean, you're basically saying he's just a mean, nasty man who wants to hurt people and discriminate against people.
I don't know him, and so that,
that's the picture that you just painted.
But his policies are awful.
That is the
picture.
A horror, I think, is what you said.
Agreed.
You know, but the other side of this is David Wohl, and I imagine you're going to present some of this, is that he's trying to return the power to the states, that this is a government that is about allowing states to do the work at their own level, whether it comes to bathrooms or their police forces, and to keep the federal government out of that. David?
Yeah, you know, I met Jeff Sessions at the St. Louis debate. He is a gentleman. He's soft-spoken, but he means business. And part of making America great again, according to him, is restoring the rule of law. Now, Richard talks about the police officers, and there were a lot of consent decrees established during the Obama administration where the federal government essentially takes over police departments. They did it in Baltimore. Look what happened in Baltimore. All of those officers who were prosecuted, all those cases were dismissed. A total disaster. The prosecutor herself is now facing malicious prosecution charges. There's immigration. There is no longer is there going to be catch and release at the border. These immigrants, illegally immigrants, are going to be detained in detention centers and taken to immigration courts, and they'll have their day in court. When it comes to bathrooms, there is going to be a permission of individual states to decide whether they're going to let men who believe they're women into the ladies' room and vice versa. A lot of states are no longer going to allow that. Mr. Obama got his claws into it and said, we'll deny you funding unless you allow it. Outrageous.
David, clearly you are trying to spin this in some weird sort of way, but here's the truth. If it wasn't for the Obama Justice Department, kids in North Carolina wouldn't be able to go to the bathroom of their choice. If it wasn't for the Obama Justice Department, the racist police department of Baltimore would not have been prosecuted. It's not, and it goes beyond the Freddie Gray case.
Racist what we police find, department?
Wait
Come
a minute.
On.
Let me finish my point. What we found in Baltimore, what we found in Ferguson, what we found in many, many police departments across this country is patterns and principles and practices of racism and violating our Constitution.
We all watched what happened in the Michael
Brown
case. I
thought he was a law and order
candidate. And the Department of Justice, you know, Eric Holder went right down there. They prosecuted the case to the fullest extent of the law. They did not find any guilt. So then they said, let's do a big evaluation of the police department. And what you have in many cases, and you know, there's no department, no matter what agency, is perfect. There are people who, are out of line. To brand an entire police department as racist, I think is really over the line.
But Martha, here's the problem. It's because of their patterns and principles that
Richard,
that officers unconstitutionally hurt
every
people of color
was dismissed.
Point blank.
And
period.
Let me say this.
Ferguson Police Department. Mandate, police department.
If states mandate that boys have to use the boys' room and girls have to use the girls'
then
room,
then that state law
what?
Is
I'm
that
okay
state law
with
is
that.
Discriminatory.
And millions and
that,
millions
that
of Americans
state
are
law
okay
is discriminatory,
that.
Just like it is to say that black people have to sit at the back of the bus.
Gentlemen,
if you're going
you
to say
kids,
that
Richard.
Trans people can't pee in the bathroom they choose, it's the same as saying
Talk
that black people sit at the back
well,
of the bus.
Well, it also has to do with the rights of the other people who are using the bathroom, and that's something that for the courts to decide, and so they shall, but he believes it ought to be at the state level rather than at the federal level.